In this video, I'm going to go over the various Wi-Fi architecture schemes and help you decide how to pick the best match. One of the most important decisions a designer must make is choosing the best system architecture from both software and hardware perspectives. This short video presents an overview of the different architectures and considerations of a system that requires Wi-Fi connectivity and where Texas Instruments comes into play. Since the fundamental goal of adding Wi-Fi to a system is enabling connectivity and communication, we will use the OSI model to illustrate the correlation between the networking layers and the different architecture schemes. OSI stands for Open System Interconnection, which is mainly a conceptual framework used to describe the functions of a networking system. The model is divided into 7 layers and can be further subdivided into 3 groups. Layers 1 and 2 to represent a local area network, layers 3 and 4 to represent a wide area network, and finally, layers 5 through 7 for the actual application data and software. There are 2 main system architectures that designers may choose from, a companion IC and a wireless MCU. Each architecture correlates to the relevant OSI layer boundaries. Texas Instruments offers both architectures, so let's discuss the characteristics of each architecture and how to choose the best fit option. A companion IC implements LAN protocols and is responsible for transferring data frames between 2 nodes in the local network. In Wi-Fi, the companion IC is responsible for controlling access to the air medium, building data frames, encrypting and decrypting data, and managing procedures like scanning, connecting, and roaming. This architecture is commonly used when the external host processor is either an MPU running in a high-level operating system like Linux, or an MCU running RTOS with sufficient memory to handle all the higher-layer protocols. This architecture allows you to easily attach Wi-Fi and/or BLE capability to your processor. A wireless MCU is a full system on chip and can operate without an external host processor. A processor is embedded inside the chip that can implement all 7 OSI layers. This means that application layer and WAN protocols, such as IP, TCP, UDP, and TLS, are implemented on top of LAN protocols, forming a complete networking solution with Wi-Fi and BLE with an MCU core that you can run your main application on. The wireless MCU is great for low-power applications and could also be used as an all-in-one solution, reducing the MCU complexity and board design footprint. There are additional factors that need to be considered before choosing the most appropriate architecture. 1. Are there any requirement limitations or considerations that negate a specific architecture? For example, can the internal network stack of a wireless MCU support enough sockets for the application? From the software aspect, what ability is there to use the networking stacks in open-source operating systems like Linux? Or is the host processor interface robust enough to meet the required throughput? Does the host processor contain enough memory and processing power? 2. Is this a brand new product or a product update where an existing Wi-Fi device is being replaced? Sometimes there is a requirement to maintain a pre-existing architecture due to a tight project timeline. Regardless of the final architecture decision, Texas Instruments can help. At TI, we offer both architectures as part of our Wi-Fi portfolio. In addition, we offer solutions as both ICs and fully certified modules. We hope that you can now effectively choose the right architecture and device for your system. If not, TI engineers are here to help you choose. For more information, visit ti.com/Wi-Fi.